Hey guys, Henning and Morten from FlippedNormals here. And today we're very excited to announce our latest product, which is the FlippedNormals Studio HDRIs.
Yes.
And these are 30, more than 30 actually, high quality balanced HDRIs based on our lighting scenes. So they're not just your everyday run-of-the-mill HDRIs in a studio where you have like a black background here and a white light here. These are actually the balanced ones that we've used from the lighting scene, but then distilled into HDRIs.
Yeah, that's been one of the key things here, that we didn't just want to make some random lights and some like cityscape stuff, which, you know, might be useful for certain things here, but we just really wanted to make something which was super good. So the lighting scene, we spend a lot of time on that. And in this one, we have just made HDRIs of them.
Yeah, and it's super easy to, like, right now we're showing it in Substance, but you can do it anywhere, really. You can just drag and drop the HDRIs that you would like to play around with. Just see what kind of lights do you get from just playing with the intensity. And the rotation really does a lot as well.
Yeah.
For the look and the feel of your object. So the cool thing is we have all the bespoke 20 base HDRIs from the lighting scene as well, but then we've created variations of those. Like, sometimes you might not want a big blue bounce light anywhere in your scene, so that we've gone in and removed for some case. Like here you can see we have a lot of blue light, which adds a lot of nice fill light to this helmet. But then maybe if we rotate it up here, we don't really want a crazy reflection of a blue light up here. Of course, it depends on the kind of object that you're rendering as well. But it makes it really easy and really fast to not just preview your model, but also make production-ready renders of it.
I've been using the FlippedNormals, I can say, like, personally for like years, just for my own stuff, just because I don't have time to do it properly with lights. So just chuck them in there, and then you're ready to go. But this just makes it even easier. Crazy lens flares. The cool thing about this, drag and drop them into any render engine, like all render engines like ever will support this, and they have supported them for a long period of time, such as V-Ray here. You simply just make an HDRI light, you just plug in the HDRI, in this case it's a dome light, you just plug in the HDRI and it's ready to go.
So for this example here, whether it was Arnold or if it's in Redshift or it was using V-Ray, whatever it
Modo,
is. Yeah, everything's supported. So
even if you're using Mental Ray?
I guess Mental Ray would support it, maybe. But so just as a quick example, just to show you how that will work in a render engine like this. So here we're going to be using the V-Ray IPR render just to get some really quick lighting. And it's the same deal as if you're using Substance. Then you go in, you can play with the resolution and the sampling of your HDRI. And maybe you wanted to rotate this one around or something to see if you can get a 90 degree rotation. And that immediately changes the feel of it.
Yeah.
And the nice thing about doing it in here, as well as when you were doing it in Substance, is it's really easy to quickly just test out new HDRIs and completely change the look and the feel of your scene and your character, your objects, or whatever's in the scene.
And this here is going to look pretty much identical to the results from lighting scenes. So, like, we have it available for our own use. I'm just going to be using this in the future.
Yeah, because this is so much easier to set up, and render times are very comparable.
Yeah.
So here as well, I'm using GI to get some nice bounce light as well. You could supplement this with additional lights, you know, so use your HDRIs as just pure reflections in the beginning and then jump over and create some actual lights to sort of refine the light setup a little better.
Like we said before, like one of the main things here compared to other HDR packs here, which might contain like 200 HDRIs and all that, is they are balanced. They are made to look nice.
Yeah.
So you already have a huge advantage right there.
A really cool thing, if now we're back here in Substance, is you could do this in Marmoset as well, if you're just previewing, because it's all real time. So before we're using the iRay render, so this is actually in the viewport, and you can see even in the viewport we get really nice reflections, and it's really easy to figure out, okay, what is this gonna look like, kind of. And then as soon as we turn on iRay again to see the real preview, you just get something that looks amazing.
So the cool thing is that you can use this straight for your portfolio renders. A bunch of people are doing that. There's no reason to really take this out of Substance ever, like into V-Ray to bake the shaders there.
No.
This is going to look just as good in Painter, maybe even better than it is in any other engine.
And just real quick, if you wanted to add a new HDRI, you can just drag it in. Say you want to pick it up as an environment, import it into your current session, and boom, it'll be there. Then you can search through and say FN HDRIs, and now all your HDRIs will be here. And then it's as easy in the viewport here to just drag and drop to create new lights and sort of preview other things. Yeah. So, you know.
So I've been working as textures quite some time now, and having HDRIs here like this is just really, really helpful for me, because some of them are very broad and you can focus on color, really just developing the albedo channel here. But other times as well, when you're making like a spec map, like the spec roughness map or the bump map, you just need like super high contrast, like essentially what we're looking at here, super high contrast stuff, and just something which just makes the spec and the bump just shine like crazy.
Yeah, that's what we're getting here. So that's really nice, and it's so easy to and fast to prototype with.
Yeah,
it's actually become more easy for me to use our HDRIs than it has using our lighting scene now. Yeah.
So our lighting scene is still great, guys. We still use it.
I would like to point out that there are different use cases for these two. It's not that one is better than the other. It depends on what you're using it for. The lighting scene is good if you want the overall customizability.
Yes.
You want to be able to change the color of your lights, the position, the individual position, and turn on and off specific lights. Whereas the HDRIs just make it really easy to quickly get a really nice lighting setup. And I think that about covers it for this product. So, you know, go test it out. Hopefully you'll enjoy it. And share the results with us.
Please do that.
We love to see what you guys make.
We get super hyped when you show that. Share in YouTube comments. Share on us on Twitter or Facebook.
Mm.
And yeah, we really hope this here is helpful for you. And you can make some super sexy renders.
Definitely. Thank you.